Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, operating system was deadlock. So this is one of the important topic. Let us see what is a deadlock. So actually a deadlock is nothing but it is a situation or a condition. First you call it as a problem. This is a deadlock, is a problem. Means it is happening something, means it is blocking something. So a deadlock problem is a condition. Let me write. A deadlock problem, it is a condition, or you can call it as a situation. It is a condition or a situation when two or more process, when two process sharing the same resources, when two process sharing the same resources or effectively preventing each other from accessing the resources, that you call it as a deadlock. So what is this sharing the same resources or effectively preventing each other from accessing the resources? That means, let us take one simple example. A P1 is a process and P2 is a process. These are the two processes. And here R1 is a resource and R2 is another resource. Now P1 is accessing R1 resource. It is already accessing, okay, means or allocated. R1 resource is already allocated to P1. But P1 is requesting R2 resources. And this side, the P2 is already, R2 resource is already allocated to P2. And P2 is requesting for, it is requesting for R1 resources. This state you call it as a deadlock. What it means? So P1 is already holding R1 and it is requesting R2. But this R2 is already holding the P2 and it is requesting R1, which is held by P1. Okay. P1 is holding R1 and P2 is holding R2. Okay. Until P2 releases R2, it doesn't access, the P1 cannot access. Until P1 releases R1, P2 cannot access. So this state you call it as a deadlock. Okay, let us take the simple example, a live example. Means suppose if you want to call your friend, okay, A and B, both are the friends. So A wants to call B and B wants to call A. So here A is dialing at the same time. And B is also dialing at the same time. So then both the persons will become engaged. So A leaves the phone and the B also leaves the phone. A dials the B's number and B dials the A number. So then both will get the engaged. No one will respond because both are dialing at the same time. That situation you call it as a deadlock. Or else you can take, this is a road. It's a narrow road. Here one vehicle is coming and another vehicle is also coming in this way. Okay. Now this vehicle wants to cross this vehicle and this wants to cross this. But here there is no space to cross. So what they have to do? So either this vehicle will come back and this will go. Or this has to take a turn and come back and this will go. But they are not ready to go back. So this state you call it as a deadlock. Because no one are ready to go back. So they wants to cross, but there is no space here. So this situation you call it as a deadlock. So these are the different examples. A deadlock means one process is requesting for the resources which is already allocated to other process. Okay. So that you call it as a deadlock state. Until that process is not released, this process has to wait, but that process is not ready to release the lock. So both are in waiting states. If both the people, a process is in waiting state, that state you call it as a deadlock state. So I hope you understand the definition. It is a situation when two processes, so these are the two processes, sharing the same resources or effectively preventing each other from accessing the resources. Now let us see the conditions for deadlock. What are the conditions? Conditions for deadlock. So the deadlock may occur when the processes are in mutual exclusion, or when the process is in hold and wait state, or there is no preemption, or it is a circular wait. The process is in circular wait. So when all these four must happen simultaneously for a deadlock to occur, so if these all four conditions leads to a deadlock, so mutual exclusion. So mutual exclusion means there is no sharing. Mutual exclusion means it is not shareable. The resources cannot be shareable. Means the process, suppose R1 resource is there. The P1 cannot, if P1 is accessing and P2 is not supposed to access that resources. So that is not shareable. Suppose if it is R1 is shareable, means P1 can access, at the same time P2 can access and P3 can access, if it is shareable. But the mutual exclusion concept means only one process can use resource at a time. Only one process can use resource at a time, and that process can enter into critical section and execute the work. Mutual exclusion means one by one. One process, after that another process, after that another process. Means it has to follow the sequence. Okay. So the main thing is mutual exclusion is not a shareable. So if it is not shareable, means obviously a deadlock may occur. Means because the P1 is wants the R1 resources, P2 wants the R1 resources, every processor wants the R1 resources, but that R1 is not shareable. Once the P1 completed, then only P2 can take and P3 can take, but all the process wants to execute at the same time. So that leads to, if mutual exclusion is there, then the deadlock may occur. Next, hold and wait. Hold and wait means, right, so this hold and wait means a process is holding at least one resources and waiting for another. Holding one resources and waiting for another. So already that process is holding one resources. It is not really, even though it is not released, that process is, it is asking for another resources. That is, one resource is holding and waiting for another to come. So that case, it leads to a deadlock. So this is one of the possible condition for deadlock. So that example what I explained previously, the P1 process, R1, P2, R2. Okay, so P1 is requesting for R2 and it is holding R1. So P2 is holding R2 and it is requesting for R1. So requesting holding. So this state you call it as a hold and wait. So this leads to a deadlock condition. Now coming to no preemption. So what you call this? No preemption. So preemption means if one process completed its work, it can send the resources back so that another process will take. But here no preemption means a resources can be released voluntarily by process itself. Okay. Only the process can itself release the resources. Until that, it cannot release the resource. Means voluntarily it can be released. So that you call it as a no preemption. Means suppose P1 acquired some resources. Let us take this P1 acquired some resources and is waiting to acquire another resources. So R1 is already acquired and it is waiting to acquire another resources R2. But P1 is not willing to give up. This P1 is not willing to give up R1. So it has already acquired. This state you call it as a preemption. preemption. Okay, so here what I'm saying is, let me write that a resources can be released voluntarily. So this P1 can voluntarily release the R1. Okay, so it has to voluntarily released by process itself. That you call it as a non-preemption. Now coming to this circular wait. What do you call this circular wait? So this non-preemption, no preemption will leads to the one of the condition for leading to the deadlock. Because this P1 is not ready to relieve the R1, but it is asking for R2. It wants the both the resources. It is not releasing the R1. Even though its work is completed, it is not releasing the R1. So that is leads to a deadlock because another process is waiting for R1. Okay, so this leads to deadlock condition. Now coming to circular wait. So what is a circular wait? A circular wait, let us take four process A, B, C, D. Let us take the four process. So here the process A acquired some resources which is needed by B. A acquired some resources which is needed by B. And the B acquired some resources which is needed by C. B acquired some resources which is needed by C. At the same time, the C acquired some resources which is needed by D. And the D is also acquired some resources which is needed by A. Here everyone is waiting for another thing. So this condition is, you call it as a circular wait. Means there is no solution for this. A deadlock state. It leads to a deadlock. So this condition you call it as circular wait. So if we prevent any one of these conditions. So this mutual exclusion. If you make any one of these conditions as a false. Then you can prevent the deadlock. You can make all the conditions false, means you can avoid mutual exclusion by sharing all the resources. You can make the hold and wait as a false statement, and you can do no preemption as a preemption. And if you avoid the circular loop or circular condition, then you can prevent this deadlock. So the main reasons for the process leads to deadlock is these four conditions: mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, circular wait. Anyone or if all these things will be there, it leads to a deadlock. Thank you.